Hello, welcome to a new tutorial in EViews. Today we are going to be talking about how to perform unit root tests on multiple time series at the same time. So this is going to be a great tutorial for those of you who are working on a research project or maybe an assignment and you need to test for the existence of a unit root on multiple time series. So instead of going one by one, you will be able to open all the variables at the same time and perform the unit root tests. If you are new to the channel, my name is Juan, I'm an economist and I teach tutorials about applied econometrics, time series analysis, and forecasting. So if these are some of the topics that you're interested in, feel free to subscribe to my channel to get a notification anytime I submit new content. Now that we are done with the introduction of the topic, let's get into this. I have a couple of series, in this case are for the US. I have the consumer price index, GDP, money supply. Doesn't matter really, we are just showing an example. You can download the data set. There's a link in the description in case that you want to replicate the content of this video. So we're going to open the three variables together as a group. We're going to start by just doing a graph. We're going to go into view. We're going to go into graph. And then we're going to change here in the multiple series. You want to select the option multiple graphs. The following graphs are going to appear for consumer price index, money supply, GDP. We can clearly see they all have a positive upwards trend. So this is already showing that the variable has a trend, that the mean is not constant over time. So it's likely this is going to have a unit root, of course. So something I like to do after creating these graphs is changing the template. I always like to go into templates, apply template. We're going to go with the option simple. I'm going to select continue. Okay. And now you get the graphs with a bit of a better format, I would say. The next thing we can do, if you want, is you can reorganize all the variables, put them one together, one after the other, just like this. There we go. And in case that you need to save this for your project and you need to put it in a Word document or LaTeX or whatever typewriting system you're using, you can always right click, save graph to your disk, and you're going to make sure you change here the extension to PNG. All right, so that's basically what you're going to do. Now, the next thing that we are going to do is to download an add-in that is going to allow us to perform two different unit root tests at the same time on multiple series. So we're going to go into the option download. Here is showing us all the available add-ins that we can install. So we're going to go all the way down. The one for the unit roots is called this one, URL. It says, provides a quick way to perform unit root tests on multiple series and summarize the results. We're going to get here the option install. We select OK, proceed. And now we have installed successfully the extension. We can see now that it's showing in the install objects, it's showing the add-in. So we're going to close this now. I'm going to go back to add-ins again. And you can see here, it's already appearing now, the extension we have downloaded is called All Unit Root Tests. So if you click in here, now it's asking the first box, enter the name of the variables. So in here, we're going to type the variables. We have consumer price index, GDP, and money supply. So you're going to type the name of all the variables that you want to perform the unit root test, sorry. And next we have to select which unit root you want to perform. You can do the augmented decay filler test, Phillips Perron, or the KPSS. And at the same time, it allows us to select the two. So we can just select this option, augmented decay filler and the Phillips Perron test. And next is going to ask, which criterion do you want to use to select the lags? So we're going to go with the Schwartz. The other option is Akaike. So we're going to go just with Schwartz for now. We're going to select OK. And here now we're going to get the results. On the top, we get the unit root test for Phillips Perron. We're going to expand this a little bit. you can see that, you know, already this is really, it's really handy, it's really helpful, because we're getting all the results. You can see with constant and trend, without constant and trend. And also you're getting the variable, the results at first difference. So this is really cool if this is something that, for example, you need to present in your, you know, in your results, in your paper, in a Word document. Everything is already summarized. You get, you see everything in levels, then in first differences. And you can go down and you get the results as well for the unit test, but in this case with the augmented Dickey filter. You can see you get the results with a constant, with constant and trend, without constant and trend, and the same you're gonna get for first differences. The results that our the results of this test are basically indicating that my series has a unit root in levels. We cannot reject the null hypothesis that the series has a unit root. You can see that the p-value is bigger than 0.05 in all of the cases. But you can see that in first differences, the series is going to be stationary because we are rejecting the null hypothesis that my series has a unit root. So this is going to be all the content for today. This was just a short video with some a small tip for you to be able to perform unit root tests on multiple series at the same time. Remember that this video is part of a free EViews course. You have a link in the description of this video to get into my website, where you're going to see all the available tutorials that I have in my website for you to check, and also all the material is there for you to download. Thank you very much for watching, and take care. Thank you.